Hello. Bunnies. Ah, bunnies, bunnies, bunnies everywhere. Where's West? That way. Let's go. Oh my goodness. The happiness. The cuteness, the joy, the colors. I am going to go completely insane, even more than I actually am. But these days, I just couldn't think of anything else. Right currently now, while I'm slaughtering all of these slimes, there are two little balls of fur hopping around my bedroom. Well, that was pretty dangerous, but I did it anyway. I have two baby bunnies. It wasn't planned. Like, one day, these guys that had a couple of bunnies, the bunnies meet, you know, did what bunnies are pretty infamous for doing. And they were like, okay, I'll get these bunnies, grab two. And I'm like, what? And here they are. The amount of cuteness that is hopping around my bedroom currently is overflowing. It's just wow. I never thought bunnies could be this just adorable. I've been squeeing uninterruptedly for 3 days in a row. I just turn around every 2 minutes, look at them, and go, "Aww, it's wow." They have right now. Wow, they have exactly 3 weeks right now. Wow! I sincerely am just this happy. I can barely express the happiness and joy I'm feeling. I know I'm bubbling. I just can't help it. Bunnies are very, very nice animals. They make for very nice pets. They're incredibly affectionate. They're clean. They clean themselves. They aren't noisy. They're pretty quiet. They're smart. They're cute. They're fluffy. That's important. They're not even expensive to feed and maintain. They just eat the... Ah, Minecraft, you're so silly. They just eat the grass that grows in your backyard and whatever vegetables you have there. So, as I said, I never planned on having bunnies. It's not like I said, wow, I'd like to have bunnies. So I start making preparations and think about it. It just kind of happened. One day I did not have bunnies. The next day I had two bunnies just in my bedroom jumping around, biting things. Okay, maybe the whole biting thingy could be one reason why you wouldn't want bunnies in your room. But still, you know. You take care of that, make sure everything is protected and they don't make messes. And yes, so this happened. And it's like one of the best things that ever happened to me. I'm just so happy. I could spend the entire episode just talking about how cute and fluffy and smart and everything my bunnies are. Ah, but you don't want that. We just got some more gold, and that's pretty amazing because I wanted to talk about this. This series here is, I mean, if it keeps going like this, I'm going to reach the Farlands before Kurt does, and that's a pretty amazing feat since the Farlands do not exist anymore in this version of the game. Actually, never mind, I don't care about the torches. So you have decided to give me yet another... Oh, another smithy. Yet another objective that I will try to accomplish. And this objective is... I want to get 40 golden ingots. So 20 more from starting now. And once I have 40, I want to stop. I just don't want to keep running. I have big plans, big building plans. Things that everybody wants to see, right? You can't wait to see a table, can't you? Can you? Come here, yeah. Am I? Wow, for a moment I thought I was playing on peaceful, I didn't see any slimes anymore. Silly Winther. I have a stack of wheat, so I need to find somebody who is willing to buy it. Hello. No? No wheat? You don't care about the wheat? I saw a house back there that had this lighting glitch, so I shouldn't get close to that. That one. I think there is even more. Hi. Are you interested in what I have to sell? Are you interested? Are you interested? Will you buy my wheat? Ooh, 7. That's a pretty nice deal. Okay, west. That way. Stay away from you. And yes, so the bunnies happened. Wow. I need to force myself not to talk about them any longer. I need to resist the cuteness. It must not have the best of me. Okay, I feel better now. I have to keep talking about them. I still don't know, they're too young, so I have absolutely no clue if they are a guy and a girl, or a boy and a boy, or a girl and a girl, and well, we will see how unlucky I might be with that. There's two of them, and hopefully they're exactly the same. Do you buy wheat? Wow, another 7 slices of melon still. Hi, what about you? Oh, come on. Nobody cares about wheat any longer. Ah, back in my days. Back in my days, everybody cared about wheat. Wow, 10 cookies. 10 cookies. Chickens. Do I look like somebody who has chickens? Nah. I can just steal the pickaxe from your chest. Oh, you don't have any. Well, I guess that makes sense. Well, I almost have a stack of iron. I guess I'm done with that too. I just want some more gold. And that's it. No more anything. That's it. I'm done. I'm settled. And yeah, so because since I still have no clue what they who and where and how they are, they still don't have names. And I just don't know. We will see. I will see how to call them. Maybe you can give me a hand. Do you know any nice bunny name? So the pre-release in completely, and now for something completely different, the 1.4 pre-release has been pre-released. I still haven't tried it. I should. Yeah, I'm curious. I really want to check it out. I have absolutely no idea how the 1.4 release will affect my challenge year, if it will at all, because of all the new super flat editions. Of course, I will not switch to 1.4 until the Ultra Hardcore mod is updated for that, but when it will be, oh, there you go. When it will be updated, as I said, I have no clue what will happen if I switch to 1.4. Ooh, more diamonds in the middle of this game, but unless you can tell me, you could tell me. Do you know anything about this? You could tell me. Oh, another one. I will take the liberty of backing up this save file. More gold, only one, however. Before switching to 1.4, then I'll start recording an episode like normal, and if anything bad happens because I switched, I updated my version of Minecraft in the middle of my game here, if anything bad happens, it will be one incredibly rare instance where I will take the liberty of reloading my backed up save file. I don't consider it cheating. I hope you don't either. I'm just not going to do anything. I just want to see if anything bad happens if I switch to 1.4 in the middle of my game. Because if it does, I'll just get back to the privacy file and stay in 1.3.1. So I hope you're not... You're fine with that. I hope it doesn't bother you. But, well, we will see in the future. Wow, that chunk reloading thingy scared the crap out of me. I thought I was going to fall in the void. Just jumping and suddenly the ground below me just disappears. Below my feet. Whoa, that's too many slimes. I just want a nice spot to sleep in, thank you. Okay, this seems safe enough. Can I sleep? Can I sleep? Yes! Don't let anything bad spawn on me. You slime, stay there. Skellies, creepers, nothing good. That's perfect. And we'll keep going. We are 19 golden ingots away from our goal. And, oh, about that, I don't know if I should, like, keep all the gold I have now. If I take damage, I do not heal myself. And I will only craft golden apples after I have completed my objective of having 40 golden ingots. And I will not travel any further away after that. Or if I should, like, keep healing away any damage I might take until I manage to get 40 golden ingots while being at relatively full health. I don't know. I really don't know. What do you suggest? Yeah, I probably... Yes, I should do that. I should... I don't care about your suggestions any longer. I should not heal any damage I take any longer until I have 40 golden ingots. So that this will add a bit to the challenge. Maybe I will stop taking stupid damage if I give myself a couple of extra rules. Alright then. No more healing from this moment onward. And this lighting glitch could be dangerous. Hi. We sell when I offender is completely worthless. Give me more wheat. There's not a lot of wheat here, so I'll grab this wheat instead. Pretty cool. Well, I think is that everything I had to say? Yes, it is. So, as long as we don't know if we will ever get carrots and potatoes in our super fat challenge, in the meantime, we will just keep talking about lucid dreams. After all, we are approaching the end of our very short, lessons? Series of lessons or something. Last time we learned... What did we learn last time? Oh yeah, last time. Good job, Winther. You know what you're talking about. You should know what you're talking about. Last time we talked about dream science, and I asked you to try and start rereading, re-listening to your own notes about your dreams and see if you what your dream signs are and how common they are, and things like that. We will get to that in a second. Now first, we need to talk about something. Have you ever seen a movie? Or have you ever read the book? Or have you ever experienced any, I don't know, any form of fiction where a character suddenly is in a situation that is incredibly weird, surreal, or unbelievable, impossible in any kind of way? And this character, because of that, the only explanation he can come up at that moment is that he just has to be dreaming. It can't be real what he is seeing. And so what does he do? To check if he's dreaming, he pinches himself on the arm. I'm sure all of you are familiar with the idea of pinching yourself on the arm to check if you're dreaming. Because the reason, I don't know why this gesture is this famous, I don't know, but it's so well known that you most likely know what I'm talking about. Just the idea of pinching yourself on the arm if you think that you're dreaming, and the reason is that if you are not dreaming, you're going to feel a little bit of pain, but if you are dreaming, you're not going to feel pain. So if you pinch yourself on your arm and don't feel pain, that means that you're dreaming. Now, what else did we learn last time? Last time we learned that to control your dreams, you need to be aware of being asleep, of being right now in a dream. So let's put two and two together. If you pinch yourself and you don't feel pain, you now know that you're dreaming. Since you now know that you're dreaming, you are in control of your dream. Wow, you have achieved the lucidity. This is our objective, and all we need to do to get a lucid dream is to pinch ourselves while dreaming. It's that easy. Wow, that sounds pretty awesome, doesn't it? It does, because we are assuming two things that we need to talk about first. But the general concept does apply. If you are in a dream and you pinch yourself and you don't feel pain, you're going to know that you are dreaming and you're going to be able to control your dream. This is the lucid dreaming equation. The act of pinching yourself is called, let's put the sneer in white text here again, step 3, reality checks. A reality check is pretty, well, it's self-explanatory. It's a gesture, an action, there we go, that's the word I was looking for. It's an action that you perform, that you carry out, and the outcome of this action is going to prove if you are dreaming or not. So if you do this action in real life, while you are definitely not asleep, you're going to obtain a result. But if you do the exactly same action in a dream, you're going to obtain a different result. This is the concept of reality checks. And stop rolling the checks like that. I swear I'm not touching anything, it just does that randomly. Oh, finally a village. It's that easy. If you perform a reality check in a dream, you're going to realize that you're dreaming and you're going to be able to control your dream. This is what we need to work to manage to do. The first problem is pretty obvious. It's the fact that, the question is, how do we pinch ourselves in our dreams? Because we cannot control our dreams. It's a creeper in the house. Oh, goodness, those are zombies too. We cannot decide to pinch ourselves while dreaming because we're not yet in control of our dreams, hi. So that is a problem. And it's a problem that we need to solve. How do we pinch ourselves while dreaming? The second issue is one we're not going to talk about in this episode. We'll do it in the next one. There are also something else that we will talk about in the next episode, because we don't have much time today, are the other kind of reality checks, because there's not only the action of pinching yourself. There are many different kind of reality checks, and they all have different, let's say, properties. Some reality checks are more appropriate for some specific situations you're in, and so learning to do reality checks is something that we will have to do and try, something that we will have to learn how to do correctly. But to answer the question that we asked ourselves before, the question being, how do we pinch ourselves in our dreams? Well, what did we learn last time? I think we were going to settle down in this village. What did we learn last time about, not lucid dreams, about dream signs? Dream signs are things, persons, anything that sometimes that you very often dream about. There are things that very often appear in your dreams, and thus, if you see them, you have a pretty good chance of being asleep and dreaming at that moment. That's why they're called dream signs in the first place, because they're a sign that you're most likely dreaming. So let's assume that, for example, there's... Should I keep going? Nah, I'm going to pick up this wheat here. Let's assume, for example, that, I don't know, there's a person, let's call him George. George is your best friend, and you dream about him very often. He's one of your dream signs. Now let's assume that in real life, every single time you see George, you try to discreetly, so that he doesn't see you, he doesn't think you're crazy, you discreetly pinch yourself on the arm. And every single time you wonder, since you're seeing George right now, you might be dreaming, so you pinch yourself. You keep doing this for a week until it becomes a habit. Every single time you see George, you're just going to pinch yourself on the arm without questioning it until it really becomes a habit, something that you always do whenever you see George. And what happens the next time you dream about George? Since this has become a habit, just like dream signs that are something that you experience daily and thus you dream about very often, your habit of pinching yourself on the arm while seeing every time you see George is going to happen in your dream simply because it has become a habit, and thus it has become sort of like a dream science of its own, something that you dream about this often, and it's triggered by a certain thing, in this case you seeing George. This is the secret to performing reality checks while you're dreaming. You take the habit of performing reality checks while you're not dreaming in your everyday life. I'll let you think about it. What did I run out of here? What did I have here? Oh, my bad. I'm amazing. Amazing Winther. What did I press? It's a very simple concept. You take the habit of performing reality checks during the day, and you will be able to perform them in your dreams too. Pretty cool, but this is still not everything you need to know about reality checks. And we still haven't talked about other different reality checks. There's not just the act of pinching yourself on the arm. Also, there's the fact that reality checks have to be performed correctly. And we will talk about what a correct reality check and what a not reality correct reality check is. And all of this is for next time. So for today, no homeworks for you. You just keep on writing down your dreams like always, trying to figure out all of your dream signs as always. And I will see you, if you want to, in the next episode of Ultra Flatcore. Thank you so much for watching, and I really sincerely hope you enjoyed it. The bunnies are telling me to tell you hi. You have a nice day. Thank you very much, and goodbye.